Welcome to the Python tutorial series. My name is Daniel Lari, and today I'll discuss about the variable scopes and one more function that is available in Python, that is globals function. So let's see one by one what is the variable scope. The question is, what is the requirement of the variable scopes understanding? So the requirement is sometimes we try to access the variables which is not available in the scope and we get error. And sometimes we go into interview and some online test, there might be they ask some question related to the variable accessing. So if you don't know that what is the scope and how to access those things, then you will do some error. So understand it very carefully that what is the scope. Scope means the accessibility of a variable, that where you can access that variable. So in Python there are four scopes are available. One is called local scope, second one is called enclosing, then global and built-ins. I have written all the scopes in the searching decreasing order, means which one will be get highest preference. So local will be get highest preference. After that, if that variable doesn't available in the local scope, then it will go and search into the enclosing scope. And after that, if that is not available in this scope, then it goes and search into the global, and after that it will search into the built-in. Okay, so what is the local and global? First I'll discuss about the local and global scopes. Only one thing you need to remember for the local is variables, okay, defined inside the function. Okay, so variables defined inside the function has local scope. What do you mean by this? Def, and here is my function one, and in function one, I'm defining one variable x is equal, and I write local x. So this will be a local to the function. It has a scope that is local to this function. You cannot access this x to outside of this function. Let's see with the example. Let's print the value of x. So here x is equal x, and let me call the function. And I call the function here, and if I run this, then you will see that we are getting output as x, local x, because we are printing this. Now if I try to access this x outside of this function, means just below this function, if I try to write print and x is equal and then x, so definitely we will get error because it is not in the scope. Let's look at here. Name error, that is x is not defined. So you will not get x outside of this function. Means its lifetime is within function, you can access and you can use. This is the local's definition. Okay, now what is global? Global means if you define in outside of the function any variable and indirect in your script file, that will be in global scope. So if I declare any variable, for example, here is my a is equal, and if I write global a, so this is the global variable. Global means you can access this variable inside the function or anywhere in your script file. This will be available to everywhere. Okay, so if I access here and print it as global a is equal, and after that the value of a, and I try to access this a outside of the function as well, so let's see what is the output of this program. So you can see that global a we are accessing inside the function, global a we are accessing outside of the function, means it is available everywhere in your application. So I hope the local and global scope is clear. One thing that you need to remember is, for example, if you try to do like this, since this a is in global variable, in a global scope, and if you write a is equal to here, and if you assign that is local x, so when the global variable and the local variable has the same name as the declaration, so you are creating two variable. Okay, so this is possible in Python. So this will be accessible in the global scope, and this will be accessible within the local scope. If I write this, for example, just A is equal, and if I try to access this A, so when your program will execute, first of all, it will search, because the local will get the highest preference. So first of all, it will search the local A. So yes, it will find the local A. So it will print the value of local A here. And after the function, I'm writing here, that is inside function. So it will make clear. And here outside of function, if I access, then this will access, since this will be accessible within the function, so this will access your outer, means the global variable. Look at here. So we are getting inside function A, local A, and outside of the function A is equal to global A. So don't be confused that you are not updating the value of the global variable. You are creating a new local variable inside the function. Make sure that if you are creating any variable, so don't create any confusion whenever you are writing the code. So this is not my recommendation to use the same name as the global and the local. Now suppose you have a local variable that you want to access in all the function that you have declared, but the requirement is you want to update the value of A inside this function as well. Okay, so how can you do this? You can do by a keyword is available that is called global. So by global keyword, you will define that which variable of the global scope you want to access inside the function. Remember this one, which variable you want to update or access inside the function. So you will write here, so I want to access the global variable A. Now when you will write this statement, so the function will understand that you are not creating a local variable, you are accessing the global variable A and you are updating the value. So if this is your global if this A is the global variable's name, so after function calling, if we access the A, it should be updated. So let's see that, is it updated or not. Yes, you can see here inside the function local A, since the variable A is updated, so you will get the value outside of the function as well, it is local A. Okay, so in the ambiguous situation, if you want to access, if you want to update the global variable inside a function, so just do and use the global keyword. So I hope this one is clear. What is the enclosing? Enclosing means this case comes when you define a nested function. Okay, so nested function means function within function. Let me create one nested function def, and here if I create inner here and print, and x is equal here x, and x is a local variable inside a function, so x is here and I'm defining local x. So this inner function is within the scope of this function. It is the enclosing within the function one. So this inner function will able to access this x. Obviously this will be very fine, this can be accessed inside this function. So let me execute this inner function here, and now I will not call the global, I'm just explaining the enclosing, so I will delete the global variable here. And if I call this function one, so definitely it will execute all the statements. So it will create one variable x is equal to local x, then it will create inner function, and inside inner function it will print the value. So I'm calling the inner function, so it will execute it. Let's see what is the output. So you can see here that x is accessible inside your inner function. Okay, now the same situation comes here. This inner function will have its own local scope. So if I write x is equal inner x, so if I execute this one, now you will get the value as inner x, not the local x. And after calling of inner, if I access the value of after calling inner function, x is equal comma x. So you will see that you are not updating, you are creating a local variable inside the inner function. So this will access your local x. So look at here. So x is inner x, fine. And after calling inner x, the local x is accessing. Now the situation is, again, this same situation comes here. Suppose you want to update the value of this enclosing variable x inside the inner. So you can do this by using one keyword that is called non-local. I have already explained this one in closer session. So I'm just recalling this. So non-local x, so it means access an inner function will access this x. So it will understand that, okay, this x is already defined outside of this inner function and inside your scope where this inner function has been defined. So now it will not create the x separate x. It will access the enclosing's local variable. So now this x will update this local variable's value. So if I call and print the value of x after inner, then we will get the value inner x. Let's see. Okay, so this is inner x, and after that we are getting is still inner x. So this is called enclosing scope. So next one is called the built-ins. Built-ins means few variables are already and few things are already available in your script file that you can use in your application. Let me show you something. For example, if I print here and I want to access min, I have already explained that min is a function that you can use to find out the minimum. So if I call min 1, 2, so it will print the minimum of 1 and 2. As you can see, how you are accessing this min, because min is available in your application. So if you want to see that how many by default built-ins are available, this is called the built-ins. So to show this, let me import first the built-ins, and I will print all the built-ins by using a dir function. I will pass built-ins here. Let me call this built-ins. Okay, so here if I print this, then you can see that there are very huge list of built-in. Let me copy all that, copy, and I will open a notepad so you will get notepad. And here, so here you can see that there are so many built-ins are available, in which you can see here these are your classes, and here you can see that the methods and the variables. So let me show you something. Min, where is min? Control F, let me find it, will save time. So here you can see that min is available. So these are the things that is by default available in your every script. So if I write this code here, just look at this. If I access this min here, so first of all, min, and here if I write 1, 2, so first of all, it will search into the local scope. If it is not available, then goes to the enclosing. If it is not available, then go into the global. And if it is not available, then go into the built-ins. If it is not available, then it will error. Otherwise, you will find some answer. For example, That's why it is recommended that if the built-ins mean the those variables and the functions which are already defined by the Python, we should not create any variable in the function with the same name. For example, if I create min is equal to 20, so now I'm creating one min variable inside the global scope that is 20. And if now I access this min, then I will get error. Why? Because it will not reach at this location, because it will start searching from the local. So it will not find enclosing, not find, but global, yes, min is available. So it will see that min is a variable and we are trying to access the min as a function. Okay, so min's built-ins will be searched at the very last. Another thing that I want to discuss before binding this this session, that is called globals function. Okay, So let me write here that is globals a function. So what is globals? So let me print first what is globals. So here you can see print, and here I am accessing globals. So you can see here we are getting so many things which are available as a global. Global returns all the global scopes value, all the global scopes value in the form of dictionary. Just look at here. So as you can see, name colon main. I will discuss about this. And one more thing you will find here, that is the Python tutorial world wonder I have already defined inside my app script. Just look at here, this one. Okay, so whatever you have defined globally will be available by using globals, and it gives you dictionary. Remember this one. Now if I define something like if I define a is equal 20, so it is in global. B is equal 30, so it is in global. And now if I call this globals, and let me show you something, because it is not very good to see into the ID, that's why I'm printing. So as you can see, A and B is also available in globals, and you can see here that it is a form of dictionary, and it is a form of dictionary. Okay, so what is the use of this globals function? I will show you only one use right now. Just look at here, understand the scenario first, then we will use. For example, if you have a function that is called fun1, okay, and the situation is it is not recommended, but I'm just discussing this one. A is equal 30. Okay, so now you are creating a local variable 30, and this is in global scope, that is 20. Now requirement is you want to have both in your function. That means you want that this A should be global, and this A should be local. And if I access I want to access this global A, then it should be accessible in my function. So how to access this? Here if I write x is equal, I will access through the globals. As you know, globals gives you dictionary. So in dictionary you can access the values by using key. So now you can see here that this is the key and this is the key. So I will write globals, and after that bracket, and I will pass A. So now it will access your global variable A, and this will be your local A. Now if I print this one, let me print A. I will write local A, and here I will write A, and after that I am writing one more statement, that is global A. And here if I write x, so you can see that both are accessible and you can use in your application. Look at here. So local A is 30 and global A is 20. Yes, you can access by using the globals keyword. Okay, so this is the way. If you want to see that this represents the same variable or not, so you can print the ID of X and print the ID of A. So you will get the ID of A and X both same. If you want to update by using this, so you can write this one like global A is equal to, for example, 100. So inside your local, inside your function, you are updating the global A. If you want to see that the function is updated, is updating this value or not, so you can print the value of A after this function. So I'm writing after function call, let me print A. Okay, so here is, I'm deleting this one now. So here the, look at here, local A is 30 and after function call, that is 100. It means we are updating the global A by using the globals function. So I hope this variable scope and globals keywords are clear. If you have doubt, then you can put your query. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any query, If you have any questions, then put your query into the comment box. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, comment, and share your views. Share the videos and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.